Today, I'm going to show you how to fix a refrigerator that won't make ice. So the first thing you're going to want to do is open the refrigerator. And full disclosure, this is actually a working ice maker. But that doesn't keep me from being able to show you how to fix one. So when you open your refrigerator, this is kind of a no-brainer, but easily forgotten. Make sure that your ice maker's on. So this would be off, and that would be on. After you've checked that, next thing you're gonna wanna do is stick your finger down in here and see if you can feel any water or ice being made. So if I was to find ice in there and it was not working, then what that would tell me is that this is not bringing that ice up and releasing it into my bowl like it should, which that's going to point to a bad ice maker unit right up here. Now if you reach in there and you feel water, that's telling you that your freezer is not cold enough, and that's unlikely that you're going to do that. Now more likely than not, you're going to reach down in there and you're going to feel nothing. It's going to be dry as a bone. So the next thing you'd want to do is go over to your refrigerator and check your filter. So this is where the filter is located on this refrigerator, and you're just going to want to make sure that it's fairly new. You might pop it out, check it, replace it if it isn't new, because what you're doing is sometimes a clogged filter can cause no water to be able to get to the ice maker to make ice. So if that looks good, it's time to pull out your refrigerator. One more thing to check is that your water dispenser works, if you have one. If your water dispenser works, that's telling you that there is water coming into the refrigerator. And so you don't have a clogged water line coming into your refrigerator. Now, if this isn't working and your filter is good, that would indicate that you have no water coming into the refrigerator from the house. So you'd want to check your water valve, make sure that it's open, and then check your water line. Then make sure that it's not clogged. Now, assuming that your water dispenser is working, your filter looks good, the next thing you're gonna wanna do is find the water line that goes up to the ice maker. And a lot of people are gonna tell you to go ahead and turn off the water supply, but I'm going to say leave it on. And before you take that off, grab yourself a bowl or a bucket. I'm going to use this just because it's handy. And you're going to want something to catch some water. But I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to undo this water line. I'm pulling off this water line, and there's no water coming out of it. But that does not mean that I should be worried or that there's anything wrong at this point. So what I wanna do is I wanna put this somewhere that'll catch water, because if this ice maker asks for water, it's gonna squirt water right out of there. Now, with that undone, I'm going to check to see if this has frozen inside the ice maker. And this is probably, more likely than not, what you're gonna find is wrong with your refrigerator. So what you wanna do is pull this out. And that's not always easy. What I'm actually pulling out is this little doohickey. So I'm just gonna push it down so that it'll come out. Now it's out. So what you want to do is you want to look down inside there and see if you have ice blocking it. And probably the easiest thing to do is just get some hot water and run it through there until the water starts coming out. And that'll clear your blockage, and then you can put it back in. Now, I'll put that back in a second, same way it came out. But let's say that you pulled this off and there's no blockage, so that's not what's wrong with it. So the next thing that that would indicate is that you actually may have a bad valve assembly. So the only way to really test that would be to see if you can get water to come out of this line. And I'm not exactly sure, every refrigerator is a little bit different, but normally if you turn the ice maker on and off a bunch of times, run water through the dispenser, eventually it'll ask for water and try to let water out of this. So you could just leave this unhooked in a bucket for a few hours, and if you have water in there, then it shows you that this valve is opening and that it's working. But more likely, if you've made it to this step and there was not a blockage, you're looking at a bad valve assembly. And so what I'm talking about is right here. If you pull off this, and I'm not gonna do it right now, it's pretty easy to find, but there is a set of solenoid valves here that meter where the water goes after it comes in from this line. One of those solenoid valves controls the water that comes out of this, and another one controls the water to the dispenser. And so what you would need to do at this point is order a new valve assembly and replace that. And like I said, the best way to confirm that it is working correctly would just be if you saw water come out of this eventually. But like I said, this is a perfectly good running refrigerator with a good ice maker, and there's no water coming out of this right now because the ice maker doesn't need water at the moment. I hope this video helped you repair your refrigerator yourself. And if it did, please take a moment to help my little family by clicking that subscribe button. We just bought 90 acres that we hope to turn into our dream farm, and we plan to post not only the how-tos that we learn along the way, but also the adventure of raising our four kids on a dirt road. I appreciate you.